The Bible says that this Christ, he has given his life as a ransom. See this, in the Old Testament, it was you take a lamb to the sanctuary, like this beautiful sanctuary, so that that lamb could take your sin. But in the New Testament, because of Jesus coming to us, it is no longer the lamb we bring. It is the shepherd himself who gave himself for the sake of the sheep. It is no longer the sheep giving themselves for the shepherd, so that the shepherd can forgive the sin. No, the shepherd came and brought deliverance, salvation, justification, propitiation. He brought to us this forgiveness of sin. And therefore the Bible says, to them that received him, he gave them the right to become the children of God. Because of Christmas, you have been made, I have been made the child of God. And the Bible says, if then we are sons, then we are heirs, and heirs with Christ, and therefore everything that Christ has, it is also ours. What a great, great privilege to host the King of Kings in our lives. That is why he was born. That is why he is here. And that's why we are asking you today, as we celebrate this Christmas 2020, we know that Jesus Christ is here for you, is here for me, despite the challenges we are faced this year. The Bible says that unto them that believe, they will not be put to shame. Therefore, this year, I want to prophesy to you that even as we head to the climax of this year, enter into the year 2021, you will not be put to shame because of Christmas. What a wonderful joy! What a wonderful joy to experientially host the King of Kings in our lives. And to us, a child is born. And to us, a son is given. And with the increase of his government, there will be peace. It will be upon his shoulders, and there will be peace forevermore. Then he is a wonderful counselor. He is the one to give you counsel in every decision you want to make. He is the Prince of Peace. He will bring peace in your family. He will bring peace in your life. He will bring that peace because he is the Prince of Peace. Then he is the eternal, everlasting Father. He is the source of every good thing. So look at this. The Bible says, do not make graven image and worship them. Here, as we are hosting the King of Kings, we are no longer to make images. No, God has given us his image. He has given us, the Bible says in the book of Genesis, that he made man in his own image and likeness. Therefore, we are hosting this God. We are going back to God because of Christmas. It is because of this that we have the joy we have, that we have the hope we have, that we have the faith we have, love we love. And therefore, it is not by power, it is not by might, it is by the Holy Spirit that you be drawn to Jesus, that you be drawn to our Father, that you will become the child of God that God has intended you to be. Therefore today, as we celebrate this Christmas, I want to encourage you that it is not by works that you be saved. It's not by works that I was saved. It is because of grace through faith. That's what the Bible says in the book of Ephesians. It is by grace through faith that we've been saved. Not of our own works, lest we boast. Jesus Christ, he was prophesied, and now he lives in us. Christ, the mystery which was hidden in ages, has now been revealed to us. And this mystery, it is Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. He is in us, and I want to ask you, as we come to a close of this, that if you have never given your life to Christ, would you consider this today, this Christmas, so that you can receive the King of Kings, you can receive the King of Glory, you can receive eternal Father, you can receive the Prince of Peace, you come in your life, give you peace, and the Bible says that whoever is in Christ, he becomes a new creation. The old is gone, and the new comes. Therefore, you'll be a new creation. The Bible says it is by believing in your heart and confessing in your mouth that Jesus Christ was raised from the dead, that you'll be saved. Therefore, wherever you're listening from, and you've never chosen to give your life to Christ, would you say this prayer after me and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is coming to give you a future and a hope in Jesus' name? Say, Lord Jesus, thank you today because of Christmas. It is a wonderful time to enjoy your presence. I accept you in my heart. I confess you with my mouth that you are Lord and Savior of my life. I pray that now you write my name in the book of life. I'm a new creation, and the old is gone, and the new has come. In Jesus' name, you are born again. Join a Bible believing church and just enjoy the presence of God, and know he who has begun that good work in you will bring it into a glorious end until the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you for watching us. As we continue, we want from the gospel of Christ to sing to you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year 2021, as God is going to bless you and do you good in Jesus' name. Amen. I wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. May you be blessed. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord do to you good. In Jesus' name, till we meet again, Merry Christmas and a blessed 2021. Amen and amen.